Hey everybody, my name is Matt Storr and I repair saxophones for a living. Today I would like to show you a pretty rare saxophone. This is a 1966 Selmer, made in Paris, France, Mark VI alto saxophone with low A. This is in pretty much mint condition. It's got all its original pads, original corks, original felts. Still plays on its original pads. Don't think it was really used too much. Now you'll notice that the bell is a bit longer than normal. Normally the bell stops around here, and you've only got two of these big bell keys on the bell. This one has three. That's because it goes down an extra half step to low A. Your low A key is on the back here, underneath the thumb rest for the octave key. And you've got here where the energy travels to this key here. Lifts this up, travels down to here. There's a little nub in there. And on the back of the low A key here, it's this guy, presses this down, and then these two arms here, which are floating above the B and the B flat, press the B and the B flat down. Now, because the brass is so skinny here, and because brass is soft metal, it's actually better to finger it by doing your low B flat and then adding the low A. But if you want, you can put all three of them down at once, but you have to press pretty hard on the low A key. Now, as far as this saxophone goes, almost everything is just like you would expect it. The only difference is that you've got the low A key here, obviously. You've got a rod that goes through the G sharp, has a pivot screw on the end of it, so it's a point. And this key is held on by two pivots at each end. You've got this key here, which is just an actuating key, held on by pivot screws. And you've got this key here, which is kind of a reverse octave key. It actually looks like they use the same key. They just flip it on a rod here. And you'll also notice that the bell-to-body connecting ring is a lot smaller, because normally this bell would be down here. So this curvature is down this way, so you've got more room between the tubes where this is normally set. So this is a bit larger. So this connecting ring is unique to the low A alto. Other than that, they play pretty much the same. You hear people say that the intonation isn't as good, or they're stuffy, or the horns just aren't as good as other Mark VIs. But that hasn't been my experience. I've played a few of these now, and they all play pretty well. This one is on its original pads, and it still plays great. Sounds really, really nice. It's nice to have that low A down there. You can see the beautiful engraving on it. And these are special order options. And you can actually still order a low A alto from Selmer today. Ornette Coleman plays on a low A Super Action 80 Series 2. Interesting thing to note is that the S here normally has colored enamel behind it. Usually it's blue. Every once in a while you'll see red. And this one doesn't have any. I'm not sure why that would be. But again, this is all original. And sometimes these will have the high F sharp key. This one does not. This is about as stock as it gets, just with the addition of the low A. But again, they play pretty well. So there you have it, 1966 Mark VI Selmer Paris alto saxophone with low A. And this is all original pads, all original felts, all original corks. About as mint as you see these, and it also happens to be a low A. So, hope you found this interesting. My name is Matt Storr. I repair saxophones for a living. If you have any comments, questions, concerns, anything I can help you with, leave a comment, send me an email, check out my website. I've got some photos of this saxophone up. I've got photos of lots of other interesting saxophone stuff, got some articles, and obviously stuff for sale, and I repair as well if you'd like to send me your instrument to repair. Hope you found this interesting, and thanks for watching.